Comprehension crosswords are a fun and engaging way for students to demonstrate their understanding of a text. It all starts with a student engaging with a text, let's say a novel or a short story. They might have read this text as part of literature groups, as a whole class novel, or in their own personal reading. This student then uses their understanding of this text to create a crossword puzzle, including clues, to be solved by someone else who has also read the text. We're going to walk through how to design a comprehension crossword in Google Slides, but you could just as easily create one using grid paper from your maths book. Let's get started. Here we are in Google Slides. Let's start by closing the Themes panel on the right-hand side of the screen. Now it's time to name our document. In our class, we've been studying the text The Tale of Peter Rabbit by Beatrix Potter, so we're going to name our document Comprehension Crossword, followed by the name of the text. This document will automatically save in your drive. Next, click and select all the placeholder content on your slide and press Delete. We now want to readjust the size of our slide to be the same size as an A4 page, in case we decide to print our crossword. To do this, select File, Page Setup, and select Custom from the drop-down menu. Change the unit of measurement to centimeters, and then enter the values 29.7 by 21. Then press Apply. The first component we are going to add to our page is the crossword grid. To do this, select Insert, Table, and create a table that is 12 cells wide by 12 cells high. With the table still selected, choose Format Options, Size and Rotation. Make your table a square by changing both the width and the height to 6.5 inches. Then click and drag your table toward the bottom right-hand corner, leaving just a little bit of space from the edge of the page. The second component we are going to add is a table to house our crossword clues. To do this, select Insert, Table, and create a table that is 2 cells wide and 7 cells high. Drag the edge of this new table so it matches the height of your crossword table, but still has a little bit of a gap around the edge. Then, drag the top cells up slightly. Click and drag to select all the cells and reduce the font size to 12. In the top left cell, write the word across. And in the top right cell, write the word down. At this stage, you may need to readjust the height of your clue table to match the crossword grid. The third component of our page is going to be a banner with the title of our text. Go to Insert, Shape, Callouts, and select a banner. We are going to use this banner called Horizontal Scroll. Click and drag your banner across the top of the page. Double-click inside your banner and type the name of your text and the author. If you like, you can highlight the text and choose a new font. We are going to use the font Merriweather. Readjust the size of your title and your author, and then center the text inside the banner. With your banner still selected, choose the Fill Color tool, the Paint Bucket, to pick a new color for your banner. We're going to choose this light green color. If required, click and drag the edge of your banner so the text fits a little more comfortably. Then, right-click and select Center on Page, Horizontally. Looking pretty good so far. Alright, let's move back to our crossword grid. Starting in the top left, click and drag to select all the grid squares. Change the text size to 16, and then change the text alignment to center and middle. Click any blank space on your canvas or press Escape to deselect your grid. We're now going to start filling the crossword grid with answers for someone to solve based on your text. So, what types of words might you include? Well, you might include key characters, events, or locations from your story. Or perhaps a word or two from a significant quote. The best place to start is the text itself. Flick back through and extract these key words. Let's start adding answers related to our text, The Tale of Peter Rabbit, by using the arrow keys to move between each new square. The process of populating your grid can be a little tricky because, unlike finder words, crossword puzzles don't allow for words to be bumped up against each other. My advice is to start with a few longer words and then sprinkle some smaller words throughout. It's a bit like smaller branches shooting out from the trunk of a tree. Now that we've got all our words added, go through now and highlight the starting letter of every word. To do this, simply click inside the cell and use the fill color paint bucket to select any color. Be really careful with this step. It's quite easy to miss the starting letters of some words, which can mess up your clue numbering. Once you're confident that all the starting letters have been highlighted, right-click the edge of your table and select Copy to copy the entire table. Then, select Slide, Edit Theme to enter the theme editor. Select the theme slide, the largest slide at the top, and delete everything on this page, including the little hashtag symbol in the bottom right-hand corner. Then, right-click anywhere on your blank slide and select Paste. Your completed crossword grid should appear with its beautiful highlighted cells in the exact same position as your original slide. The next step is to delete all the letters from our grid. Unfortunately, you can't just select all the cells and press Delete. That will delete the whole table. It's best to click and drag small chunks of the table and delete them one at a time until all the letters are gone. Your highlighted cells should remain unchanged. Now, go through each of your highlighted squares and start adding numbers. Start with 1 and increase by 1 with each new coloured square. Crossword numbering always starts at the top left and moves from left to right before taking a new row, a bit like how we read a page in a book. Go through now and add your numbers. We've got 10 numbers in our crossword, but you might have more or you might have less. As we've done previously, click and drag to select your entire table. This time, however, change the text alignment to left and top. With the table still selected, change the font size to 8. Then, in Format Options, Text Fitting, change the padding top to 0.03 and the padding left to 0.03. This should place all our numbers snugly in the top left-hand corner. After this, select the border color tool, the little pencil, and select Transparent to switch off all our borders. Then, select the fill color tool and again select Transparent. Click anywhere on the slide to deselect everything. What we have done here is create our crossword numbers on a master slide. What this means is that the person completing the crossword can't accidentally move or change these numbers. They're locked in place. Close the themes panel using the little X in the right-hand corner. We are now back in the standard slides view. To make our numbers show through to this slide, click and drag to select our entire crossword grid and turn the fill color to transparent. And hey presto, we can now see our numbers. Again, select the entire crossword grid and switch the border color to transparent using the little pencil icon. Our next step is to select all the words on our grid and apply a black border color. You should see your crossword grid starting to look a little more familiar at this point. Now, let's turn our attention to the crossword clues section on the left. Highlight the cells with the words across and down. Change the text alignment to middle bump up the font size to about 14, and make it bold so it stands out. Now it's time to start adding our clues. Let's start with one across, which has the answer garden. Now, there are a number of ways I could present this clue in relation to the tale of Peter Rabbit, but I'm going to show you two possible options. I could make my clue a bit more like a traditional crossword clue, which might read, "The place that Mrs. Rabbit tells her children not to go." Six letters. Or I could make it a little more like a closed passage and leave out a key word for the solver. This might read, "Mrs. Rabbit tells her children not to go into Mr. McGregor's blank." Six letters. Now, both these clues would work, but I'm going to use the second option because it gives the solver a little bit more information. I generally recommend using a combination of these clue types throughout your crossword. Go through now and come up with clues for all your answers. To create the underline for missing words, hold down Shift and press the hyphen key next to 0 on your keyboard. Also, make sure to include how many letters the answer has by adding the number in brackets after each clue. If you need to add an extra row to your clues, you can right-click the table and select Insert Row Below. My last tip is to keep an eye on your clue numbering. Make sure the clue numbers and the direction match what the solver sees in the grid. Alright, looking good. Once you've added all your clues, highlight all the cells in your clue table and turn the border to transparent. Then, select all the clues in the across column without selecting the top cell. Click the little down arrow in the top right-hand corner of the cell and select the icon that looks like a square. Then, use the pencil tool to add a black border. Repeat this same process to add a black border around your down clues. Then, select the two top cells, across and down, and add a black border to them as well. Now, this crossword is looking pretty much ready to go, except we've still got our answers sitting in the grid. Now, that might make things a little too easy. As we did previously, go through and delete all the letters by selecting small chunks of the table. Notice also how your numbers don't get deleted. The very last step is to reset all the formatting for the person who will solve your crossword. Select all the cells in your crossword grid and change the font size to 16. Then, change the text alignment to center and middle. And there we go. Your crossword is all set to either print or share with someone else to solve. We hope you enjoyed creating your very own comprehension crossword, and we also hope that the person solving your crossword enjoys it too. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon. Hey there! If you like what we do here at Teach Wonderful, make sure to subscribe to our channel. You'll also find plenty of amazing teaching ideas, student worksheets, and merch over at teachwonderful.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.